the same time, rich and poor. Rich probably, they mean here, rich physically, with the possession that he got, and poor, spiritually poor, definitely. Good Master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? Very good question. And I think we should also ask ourselves, what shall I do to inherit the kingdom of God? As you know, the Lord answered the young man's question. He said, if you will enter into life, keep the commandments. Don't steal, don't kill, don't sin against purity. Honor your father and mother. Love your neighbor as yourself, and so on. And he answered to Christ, I have kept all the commandments you are telling me. What else must I do? What else? Okay, Jesus said, okay. First of all, I would like to say that this man made a mistake that so many of us, dear brothers and sisters, do make. For most people, we convince ourselves that we are pretty good, that we don't really sin, and that we are quite good. And one of the great tragedies in this case of our age is nowadays that we have lost a sense of sin. We really lost a sense of sin. Those who now are at age, let's say 50, 60, we know 40 years ago, 30 years ago, to stay with somebody, young people, I mean, in the house, and live like husband and wife without God's blessing, without marriage, in the church, nobody even think about that. Nobody. Nowadays, it's like to a normal. Lots of things change, upside down. That's why no wonder we have in the world, because our mind in lots of directions changed upside down. That's why we have so many bad things going on in the world, almost in each country. So I want to come back to the idea that we have lost a sense of sin. When a person comes to the confession and stands there in front of God and says, so please confess your sins. And sometimes person doesn't know what to say either. В России бы сказали, ну идите домой и подготовьтесь как следует. Вот. потому что человек даже не знает, чем каяться. Или же сказали бы ему, как профессор Осипов говорит, батюшка говорит в таком случае, ну, если вы не знаете, нечем каяться, так зачем пришли тогда? Вам вообще безгрешный человек, святой. Вот, зачем вообще прийти сюда? А интересно, смотрите, человек все-таки чувствует, что он грешный, правда? Как и этот молодой юноша, он все-таки соблюл все заповеди, можно сказать, а все-таки подошел ко Христу и сказал, а все-таки, а что мне, вот, чего мне не достает? Поэтому очень важно, когда мы приходим на исповедь, конечно, хорошо бы пройти через книгу и поразмыслить, вспомнить, записать даже себе наши грешки. И с чувством как-то пройти через эти грехи. Потеря чувства греха. Вот то, что сейчас в наше время очень сильно нами владеет. The prophet Isaiah, по-русски Исаия, есть такой пророк Исаия, Isaiah, the great prophet once cried out, воскликнул. Woe unto me, for I am a sinful man. Горе мне, грешному человеку. Пророк, Божий, такие слова говорит. Saint Paul called himself the chief of sinners. Назвал себя самым главным грешником. Первым грешником в данном случае. Да? Saint Peter cried out to the Lord. Христос приблизился к нему, он говорит, Depart from me, O Lord, for I am a sinful man. Отойди от меня, Господи, я грешный человек. And we come back to the young man, and please, he knows, and we should remember as well what God is telling us to his creatures that are создание. I am the Lord thy God, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Anything, my friends, that takes first place in our hearts and anything that takes first place in our hearts and lives is our God. Idolatry. So the Lord God prescribed the only medicine that could save that young man. He said to him, if you want to be perfect, go and sell what you have and give it to the poor and then come and follow me. That's what we were talking about in Russian. So sell your the most bigger passion, страсть. Постарайся избавиться от меня, to get rid of it. And this man, as you heard from the Holy Gospel today, he went away alone because he was so attached to himself and his wealth. Очень привязан к своему but God's own. Our Lord, dear brothers and sisters, used this occasion to warn his, warn his followers how difficult it is for the rich people to inherit the kingdom of God. This is so not because they are wealthy, but because they have put their wealth, God's wealth, first and foremost in their lives. They made a god out of gold. And we must remember, that even a beggar can do this. Не обязательно быть богатым человеком и быть, скажем, скупым, да? И к Богу, и к церкви, и к ближнему. Можно, быть очень бедным человеком и грешить этой слабостью, грешить этой страстью. As the doors of opportunity open up to us in our land, in our life for fine education here on earth, we are getting good education, training, and culture. Maybe not neglect the one thing needful for happiness here and hereafter. So maybe not turn our back on Christ and His Church, but maybe come to know them, love them, and serve them faithfully as children of God. Amen. Thank you for your attention. Во имя Отца и Сына Святого.